Hello everyone! I'm back and today I'm going to teach you something very interesting. I normally choose my videos because I can see my students struggling in class trying to do the right thing. So I normally see this kind of mistake. When you have verbs that are transitive, sometimes they require two complements. For example, I gave the book to Peter. The book is the direct object. I gave what? I gave the book. And Peter is the indirect object. I gave the book to whom? I gave the book to Peter. So if the verb requires two objects, a direct object and an indirect object, you have two possibilities. That's it. So the first one is you are going to use the direct object first. I gave the book, direct object, to Peter, indirect object. Or you can do the opposite. You can say, I gave Peter, which is the indirect object, the book, direct object. So you can put the direct object first and then the indirect object, or you can put the indirect object first and then the direct object. Which one is more common? Which one do we hear more often? The first or the second? We hear the second one more often. I gave Peter the book. I gave my sister a cell phone. Why do you think we hear the second option more often? Because you don't have to use a preposition. You don't have to think about which preposition should I use. Is it to? Is it for? And especially for ESL students, prepositions are very complex. So if you want to stick to this one, if you want to stick to this one, I think it's a better option. But if you decide to use the first sentence, the first model, you have to know which preposition you are going to use. For example, when we give something to someone. So I gave the book to Peter, or I gave Peter the book. Here I have another example. I will buy Mark a shirt, or I will buy a shirt for Mark. Did you notice that I used different prepositions? And when I say that the first one here, this one is easier, it's because you don't have to think. Buy two or buy four? Well, when you buy something for someone. So let's go back, let's recap. If the verb is transitive and it requires two complements, a direct object and an indirect object, you have these two possibilities. You can use the direct object first and then the indirect object, or you can use the indirect object first and then the direct object. I personally prefer the one that uses the indirect object first. It's more common, it's faster, it's easier. So remember this and try to use these new patterns. Okay, I hope it helped and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.